evening, brethren.
Good evening.
As I consider this, this time, and encouraging you all with the past year, I was considering that a common denominator that all men live by and work around is time. It's a common stewardship given by God to everyone that ever lives. Men are given differing measures of time, but all are given some time. Depending how time is used, it can be for you or it can be against you. It can be to your blessing or to your cursing. Where you spend eternity boils down to what you did with the measure of time you were given on the earth. So since my focus is to encourage you with the time that's already spent the last year, I thought about what do people spend? They spend money, they spend themselves, and I was reminded of Paul. Remember when he says he was willing to spend and be spent for the people of God? And then we spend time. But one of the things with spending is you're using whatever you're spending to gain something else back. It's a trade. So something unique about time, though, is that you are forced to spend it. You can't save it up. You can't save time. You have to spend it. When men spend either money themselves or time, you get something in return. So it is true, we can't go back in time that's already spent. It is gone. But you did spend or trade or exchange that time for something else. So I wanted to kind of use those other examples to get our minds thinking on how we can look at last year as that time is like a currency. And then we can see what we've bought, what we exchanged it for with the last year. I've considered how much time we spend together here as a body assembled. We have gained from doing this. The Lord has increased our understanding. He's increased our love for Him and for His people. The time from last year is spent, but we are still reaping the benefits from what was sown during that time. So even though 2013 is gone, it's not lost or like void or with none effect. It's been used up. Like consumed. You know how you consume food and it gives you nourishment? It's like the time is consumed and we're still reaping the benefits from it.
Amen.
The time that we spent last year reading and discussing the Word of God, singing hymns and spiritual songs, praying and exhorting one another has fed our desires for heaven. So compare that with people who spent their time for themselves. They have traded it for something that did not satisfy, and they have suffered a loss. We have traded time to ready ourselves to meet the living God, which is what the desire of our hearts is. Why should we take time to remember what happened in 2013? We don't want to be overly simplistic and say, well, since it's already passed, what makes any difference what happened? We can't get it back, so what does it matter? Well, if time wasn't important, then why would God give us the capacity to remember? Or better yet, why would there be a judgment day? It is an important aspect of salvation to remember, and the scriptures exhorts us to do so. I considered Isaiah 51:1 says, "Hearken to me, ye that follow after righteousness, ye that seek the Lord. Look unto the rock whence ye are hewn, and to the hole of the pit whence ye are digged." Since our memory is a battleground of the soul, meaning it can be your friend or your enemy, I wanted to exhort us with a few considerations for when we do recall the last year. Now, this word is for believers that are living by faith. Don't let time that has passed condemn you. Now, if anyone is in sin, or if anybody's listening who's in sin, you've got to rectify that. You've got to run to Christ and get out of that, or it will condemn you. But for believers who are walking by faith, don't let the time that's past condemn you. If you focus on what you were, it can. It has the capacity to do that. Time is a primary weapon in Satan's arsenal. He will use it against you as often as he can. God said in Hebrews 10:17, their sins and iniquities will I remember no more. He isn't the one bringing up your past and throwing it in your face and saying, do you remember this? Do you remember that? Satan is the one that does that. While it's important for us to recall the state from which we were saved and even to consider things just in the past year, that can't be where we set our gaze. Satan will try to shift our gaze from off the Lord Jesus Christ onto ourselves. And it's incredibly subtle. That was one of the things I was considering. He is the deceiver. If we linger too long considering our shortcomings, our faults, our mistakes, our weaknesses, or even sin that we had committed and already confessed, that can be a means for your conscience to be defiled all over again. And we can't serve God with a defiled conscience. So when you survey your own life over the course of this last year, you've got a resolve and purpose to primarily remember God. Yeah. When you look back and you consider how God worked on your behalf, how he did things for you, what he did for you, how he gave you grace to sustain you, that will sanctify our recollections of the last year. Amen. Remembering this way works in us a humility and a thanksgiving to God. Amen. Instead of defiling our conscience and alienating us from God. We want to be able to walk away from our remembering the last year feeling comforted, not condemned. Another thing to do with 2013 is to learn from the last year and let it exhort you. We as believers can use time to our advantage. If in our recollections we do remember a situation or a circumstance that we feel we could have handled better, we don't just have to dwell on it. We can just confess it to the Lord and move on and then not squander the opportunity again. But also in our recollections, when we recall high times of fellowship with the Lord, those recollections are packed with nourishment. They have the power to continue to feed your spirit and the inner man. And the Lord, as you continue to meditate on those things, he'll continue to open them up and you'll be even increased larger. The goodness of God cannot be exhausted, so we can be exhorted to keep digging in deeper. If we've made progress in the Lord this year, and I know everyone here has, praise God. It didn't happen by accident. Let the passing of time comfort you. We all recall the phrase, and it came to pass. As we continue to sojourn through this life, we can be glad and comforted that the things that were in 2013, some things we don't want to relive anymore. We won't have to. They'll be left in 2013. So the passing of time, it's also a continual reminder. Brother Ricky just said that the day of the Lord is coming. It's growing nearer and nearer. And soon we'll be beating our swords into plowshares and our spears into pruning hooks and learn war no more. Our hope of what is to come when time has run its course is a comfort to the people of God. Yeah. One last thing I wanted to encourage us to do with 2013 is to judge ourselves. 1 Corinthians 11:31 says, "For if we judge ourselves, we should not be judged." We can use this mark of the passing of a time as sort of a mini judgment for ourselves. We are being conformed into the image of Christ now. Jesus is preparing a place for us now. The time of change is right now. We can use time to judge ourselves and cast off whatever is not like Christ and whatever will not enter into eternity. But that's not all. It's also time for us to put on the new man and to culture a hunger and a longing for things of the heavenly order. We will soon be receiving our new bodies and our inheritance, even Jesus Christ. So if we continue to judge ourselves by faith and make the necessary adjustments as we survey what we, you know, what we have this past year, then we'll be able to give a good account to God on the day of judgment. Until then, start giving accounts to the Lord now.
Yeah.
It blesses God when you confess to Him what you have seen.
Yes.
God wants to be made known, and so it was just a blessing to me to think that you bless God when you confess to Him and perceive His working and His goodness. Philippians 3:13 and 14 says, "Brethren, I count not myself to have apprehended, but one thing I do, forgetting those things which are behind and reaching forth into those things which are before. I press toward the mark for the prize of the high calling of God in Christ Jesus." So what do we leave in 2013? I'm not going to give you a list. I'm just going to exhort you with whatever defiles your conscience, leave it. Yeah. Protect your conscience. Your confidence is directly related to it, and you can't afford to lose that.
Amen.
And what do we take with us into 2014? Whatever helps you to keep your focus on Christ and to lay hold of eternal life. That's what we want to bring with us. The truth that you've seen, the people that have encouraged you. And what about godly aspirations that you received in 2013? Things that the Lord has directed you in. Things that He wanted you to look more in depth to. Don't let those things fall to the ground. Pick those things up and bring them with you also into 2014. Godly aspirations are bigger than what we are able to do. But when we put our hand to the work that God has given us, He will undergird those efforts and give us grace to labor alongside with God. So Brother Mike's going to encourage us now with the new year.